Hello, hello, and this is Notary Life with Kimmi. So today, guys, we're talking all things journal. This is my journal. I've had about 5 of them, maybe more. I can't even keep count. But I'm going to tell you a couple stories, and I'm going to tell you why you need to have a journal, okay? So I'm in the state of Georgia. It's not even a requirement to have a journal. It's recommended, but not a requirement. So sometimes if something is recommended and not a requirement, we do what we want to do. But I'm going to tell you what you should do, probably, to save yourself. A couple stories first. So I'm out and about doing notarizations and I get a phone call. So it's from a man in California and he tells me that I did a notarization here in Georgia that I should not have done and that it could not have been the person that signed. It could not have been. He was 100% sure. He said Mrs. Smith never would have signed that document. So, like I said, I'm out and about already working. So I said, well, let me get back to my office. I'm going to do a little homework and I will give you a call back. So I get home and I tell my husband, I'm like, hey, this man called me. And he was like, I did a bad notarization and the person never would have signed. And he was like, calm down, Kim, calm down. Because somebody call you with that kind of news, you're like, oh my God, my whole career, my money, my house, my everything, you know? So he was like, calm down, where's the journal? So we go get the journal, I look at it, and I call the man back. And I say, hey, so can I get a few more details about that? So he tells me what's going on and found out he was living in this woman's property. And he just did not know that the woman had sold the property for whatever reason. I'm not getting all that. But he went down to the courthouse and he found out that I was a notary on record, looked me up, which is not hard to do. So he Googled me, found me, and called me and told me what was going on. So I go and get my journal and I say, well, let me double check and see what's going on. So as I'm looking at my journal, fortunately, I take really good notes. I'm going to get to that later. But I look at my journal. I remember the transaction only because I looked in here. I had written down that the lady came to my home, that she had to sit down in a chair. We provided her with a chair. She came with her daughter. We were in the street because she couldn't make it in my driveway. So it was a lot of details that I had written down. So I'm talking to him and he's telling me, well, I'm going to get the lawyer. And I said, well, that's fine. You can get a subpoena and let me, you know, and we'll follow the due process. But actually, I can't give you any more information about what's in my journal because I can't identify him over the phone. I don't know who he is. So fortunately, I had my journal. I went back and referenced everything. And as I told him, I said, well, according to what I have, she did appear before me. And everything I have is documented. So he's telling me about his lawyer and all this and all that. I said, well, that's fine. Again, as I stated before, you can present me with whatever necessary documents your lawyer's requiring, and it will go from there. So I never heard nothing else back from him. So thank God I had my journal. In the journal, I had written specifics about the lady being here with her daughter, that I had to take her a chair, certain specifics to jog my memory. Because if you think about it, can you remember what you had for breakfast yesterday? Can you remember even what you had this morning? So imagine somebody calling you 6 months later and saying, hey, you did something and you don't remember. That's story number one. So fortunately, number two. So I am sitting on my porch, just, you know, having a nice chill morning. I get a call from an attorney. The attorney says, Kimberly, we need you to have a documented form that you need to have notarized that you were the notary on this document of a sale of property and that you did see two witnesses because the lady has since died. And I was like, oh, wow. Okay, so here we go again. Now, this is months later. This one, I think, was 8 months later. So I don't remember anything about that. I see hundreds of people. I do long sign-ins. I do general notary. I go to hospitals. I do everything, right? Fingerprinting. There's no way I can remember every client. There's just no way. So anyway, I get my journal and I look at it. Fortunately, again, it was in another journal, so I had to go get that one. So I go get the journal and I look at it and I said, oh yeah, I do remember that because we had to go from one house. And then she said, well, I don't want to use these witnesses that she didn't know. We had to go to drive about 20 minutes away to another house to some witnesses that she knew. She wanted her own witnesses. So that's fine. But again, it was something weird that happened with the transaction, which jogged my memory. And fortunately, I had it written in my journal. So what I did, I had to say, well, was this my error? So it wasn't an error that I made. So now they're actually wanting me to do another transaction, basically, because the lawyer is sending me a document. She wants me to print it. She wants me to get it notarized. So that means more money, right? Somebody got paid for the notarization. I can't do my own document. So I had to call a fellow notary and I let the people know involved that, hey, you're going to have to pay me to pay this notary to come do a notarization for myself. So they were fine with that because after I realized it wasn't an error and it was just something that needed to be done to complete the process, basically. And it was all fine and well. So the other notary came and she did the notarization. They sent me the money and I paid her. So again, a journal is so important because it's going to jog your memory as to what happened. And in that case, again, it was something weird. And it's funny because when I do repeat clients, they often say, well, you remember me, don't you? And I'm saying, no. The only way I remember my clients, and I hate to say it, is if it was a crazy transaction. Like I had somebody call me one time at 9 at night. Well, I closed at 6 and I did it. You know, so I won't forget him. Or if I got there and I mentioned, like I said, the pet ran out on me in another video. So I remember that house, you know. So unless it was something weird with the transaction, or I had another time a lady called and she says, well, I don't want to come to a residential home because my husband answered the phone. So she thought it was just him here. So I remember that. So I've done like 3 or 4 for her now and she'll always remind me, you know, I'm the lady that didn't want to come to your house because I thought it was just the man there. So it's so funny. So the journal is so important. So guys, you might want to try the Integrity Notary Journal. Again, that's by Clyde Heppner out in California. He is a notary, so he knows what documents we need and all the different spaces for ID, signatures. So it's made very well. And as it mentions here, it's a single signing view. And the reason I love it is because it's just that. The one whole page is for whatever signing you're currently doing. So I've had other journals where I have to try to hide my journal from the next signer because they can see how much the other person paid. They can see their address and all that. But this journal is designed for one signer, one complete signing rather, I should say. So it's actually room for 4 signers or 4 witnesses, whatever combination you have, and you would just check the box there, your identity, whatever you use for that. Also, whatever document you used, you can show that here. You can just do a check mark. And what I really love about it is all this space here in the middle. The space in the middle, that's where I would write the document, anything interesting about the signing that's going to jog your memory later. So I have plenty of space to write it. So get your copy on Amazon if it's something that you feel you can use per your state. I always say check your state. So let's go over again why it's so important. I had to write this down, guys, because I want to make sure I didn't miss anything. So you always want to write a beginning date and an end date in your journal. That's very important because, again, that way, if you have more than one journal, which you will throughout your career, you can say from January 1 through July 1st, I use this journal in case something comes back and you have to use it as a reference. Always write extra details. Again, anything that's strange that happens at your notarization, you want to make sure you document it. Like I mentioned with the lady earlier, I had given her a chair and I knew she was extra tired for some reason. So I had written that down. Her daughter came with her. You want to write down if you're in a hospital, was any staff there? Did anybody see it? Was it a nurse there? Was it an aide in the room? If you're at a school, are you in the parking lot? Was it raining? Is it late at night? Were there any witnesses? Make sure you record their information in the journal too, because you may get subpoenaed and say, well, who were the witnesses to that signing? So you want all of that written in your document. Were there any pets? Were there any smells? Anything that's going to help you to remember that signing, because again, once you leave, more than likely you are not going to remember. It's just another notarization until the phone rings. So I've gone over several reasons why you need to have a journal. Again, this is state specific. Always check your state because California, I know, has very specific things they have to put in your journal. But again, in my state, nothing's required at all. So check your state and see what's required. And you always want to have a journal. This is your memory. So make sure you have a journal. See you later. Thanks for watching. This is Notary Life with Kimmi.